Do you still remember the thing that was disassembled by you when you were a kid? It was great fun, if you can put everything back again. Nevertheless, I still believe that disassembling is a great way to learn a complicated thing. Can we apply this old method to the learning of Geant4 that has so many components and is written in C++? Maybe we can select the simplest Geant4 example, basic B1, break it into pieces, and then try to put them back one by one. There's no serious consequences if we cannot put it back together, because we still have B2, B3, and B4. By the end of the disassembling, there should be only one Geant4 component left in this program. Guess which one is it? And how many lines of C++ is left? To help you make a reasonable guess, let's check how large the basic B1 example is. In total, there are 462 lines of C++ code in the simplest Geant4 example, distributed in 13 C++ files. 6 of them are header files. They're in the include directory. There are also 6 source files in the src directory. There is also an example b1.cc file that includes the C++ main function, which calls all the classes and functions declared and defined in the include and src directories. This is already a lot for someone who is new to Geant4 and C++. As our first goal is to break things apart, let's just go ahead and delete everything in the include and src directory that are specific for this particular example, B1. Of course, a better way would be to create a new directory called, for example, test, and then copy and paste the example b1.cc file from the old directory into this new directory. This way, we can leave the b1 directory untouched. Let's open the copied file with a text editor and delete from the first line to line 30 and 31 that include 2 B1 header files that have been excluded from our project. We also need to search for anything that is related to B1 in this program and delete them all. The rest header files are all from Geant4. Which one should we delete next? This is an easy pick. We just need to delete the header file that is related to the random number generation. Why? This is because this is optional and hasn't been used in the original B1 example. Let's delete them all. The next one to be thrown away is a Geant4 component that is related to the visualization of detector geometry. We have deleted everything that is specific to B1, include its geometry. There is nothing left for us to visualize. Let's remove them all. You know what? Let's just delete the run manager and the physics list as well. Why? Because we can't run a simulation without a detector, and there's no need to have a manager and a physics list for it. Any headers related to the run and the physics list can be gone as well. Now, the only Geant4 component left in this program is related to the user interface. Can we still get rid of one of them? We can tell from their names that the second one is the guy who really does the job. The first one is simply a manager. Let's just get rid of it. And anything related to it can be deleted as well. Now let's just do a little cleanup. These three lines here are very typical in C++. The first line creates an object of the G4 UI executive class called UI in the memory. The second line uses this object to call a function session start defined in the G4 UI executive class. The third line deletes this object from the memory after its usage. If we don't use the keyword new to declare a piece of memory for our object, the object will be deleted automatically at the end of the program. We can save one more line. We have to change from the error to a dot. Since UI is now in a reference to the object instead of a pointer to it. Ta-da! We've just created the shortest Geant4 application in the whole human history. It serves as a start point for us to add back individual Geant4 components one by one. But before that, we'd like to compile and run it. And whenever we add something new to it, we're going to compile and run it again to see the difference. That's why we need to copy and paste the cmake-lists.txt file from the original B1 example to the new test directory. Let's see how to modify it to make it work for our modified super short example b1.cc file. First, let's change the name of the project to be the same as our executable example b1. Second, we can delete anything that is related to the include and src directories that have been removed from our project. Next lines are related to the copying of some of the script files, which were never included in this project. Let's just delete them all. This block is for internal Geant4 use. For sure, we can delete it. The last line is used to install the executable. We just need to compile it. We don't have to install anything. So let's just delete it. Okay, that's it. Let's take a look at what we have right now. In the newly created test directory, we have two files, cmake-lists.txt, that can be used by cmake to configure your project. The latter one is example b1.cc file, which contains a very short C++ main function. We can compile it exactly the same way as we compile other Geant4 examples. Create a build directory in the test directory. Get into it and run ccmake space dot dot, which points to the parent directory. In the cmake text-based user interface, press C to run the configure command. Double check if your Geant4 installation is properly found by cmake. And then run configure again until you see another item called generate appears in the bottom of your screen. Press G to run it. Upon a correct generation, cmake will quit automatically. Four files and directories are generated by cmake. One of them is called makefile. Type make to use it to compile our program. After the compilation in the build directory, we should be able to find an executable file called example b1. Type dot slash means the current directory, followed by example b1 to run it. The only Geant4 components using our main function will list all the available user interface session types in the first line, starting from graphic ones and end with text-based ones. Geant4 will try to launch the first one it found if you don't specify anything. This is a Qt-based graphic user interface. It looks rather Qt. In the sidebar, it lists all the Geant4 commands that is available for you. They are grouped in directories. Single click to expand a directory. select any one and a short guide of it will show up below it. Double click allows you to copy and paste it automatically to the place where you can hit return and run it. It can be a homework for you to find out why there is an error message. For now, let's just type in exit command to quit from it. In Windows, the compilation process is slightly different, where we can use the graphic user interface of CMake.
Drag the cmakelist.txt file into the CMake GUI to fill the source and build directory, changing the build directory to a subdirectory called build. Press configure, answer yes.
If you haven't installed Visual Studio, you have to install it first. If you already have it, click on finish to accept the default.
Configure again, press generate and open project.
In the Visual Studio window,
change from debug to release. Right click on example B1, select build. The build is successful. The location of the executable is in the release subdirectory inside the build directory. We can go into it, double click on it to run it.
In Windows, the first available user interface is Win32, that is the simple white front window.
Type ls to list all the available Geant4 commands. You can cd into one of them, and ls again to list the command in that directory.
Type in exit command to quit from it. To distinguish our program from the original Geant4 example, let's give it a new name. How about Mangle? Mini Geant4 Learning Example. It means mix. That's kind of what we want to do, to put different Geant4 components into it and see what we can achieve with them. To be more professional, let's create a README file. And upload the package into GitHub so that more people can download it and use it.